أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فمن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا أو كذب بآياته أولئك ينالهم نصيبهم من الكتاب حتى إذا جاءتهم رسلنا يتوفونهم قالوا أينما كنتم تدعون من دون الله قالوا ضلوا عنا وشهدوا على أنفسهم أنهم كانوا كافرين قال ادخلوا في أمم قد خلت من قبلكم من الجن والإنس في النار كلما دخلت أمة لعنت أختها حتى إذا اداركوا فيها جميعا قالت أخراهم لأولاهم ربنا هؤلاء يضلونا فآتهم عذابا ضعفا من النار قال لكل ضعف ولكن لا تعلمون صدق الله العظيم آيات نمبر 37 we had already studied. It gives us the picture what the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to these unbelievers who associate others with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they come to take possession of their souls at the time of their death. Aynama kuntum tad'una min dunillah. Where are those gods and goddesses whom you want to pray, who you used to pray besides Allah? قَالُوا ضَلُّوا عَنَّا وَشَهِدُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ أَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا كَافِرِينَ. They will say they have just vanished from us, gone with the wind. And they will testify against their own selves that they were actually unbelievers, rejectors of the faith. قَالَ ادْخُلُوا فِي أُمَمٍ. Then they will say, those angels, now go and enter with those generations, قَدْ خَلَقْ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, which passed before you, min al jinn wal ins, min al jinn, from jinns and ins and humans, finnar, and you also enter with them in the fire. Kullama dakhalat ummatun la'anat ukhtaha. Whenever a generation will enter the hell, fire of hell, it will curse the previous one, the like of it. Hatta idha daraku fiha jami'an, when they will all be gathered in that fire of hell. قَالَتْ أُخْرَاهُمْ لِأُولَاهُمْ. The following one should say to the preceding one, رَبَّنَا هَا أُولَىٰ يَضُلُّونَا. Our Lord, these are the people who led us astray. One generation after the other, the former generation leads their offsprings, their sons and daughters in a direction. So they will blame that they were our forefathers and they led us astray and they led us to this misguidance. فَأَضَلُّونَا, they are who led us astray. فَاتِهِمْ عَذَابًا ضِعْفًا مِنَ النَّارِ. So give them double punishment from fire. قَالَ لِكُلِّنْ ضِعْفٌ. Allah would reply, for all of you are double. For all of you, all of you will get the double punishment. وَلَاكِ اللَّهَ تَعْلَمُونَ. But you don't know. Because had your preceding generation led you astray, you had also led astray the next generation which you left behind you. So actually this is a circle going on, vicious circle. So for all of you, the punishment will be doubled. وَقَالَتْ أُولَاهُمْ لِأُخْرَاهُمْ. On this, the previous one would say to the next generation, فَمَا كَانَ لَكُمْ عَلَيْنَا مِنْ فَضْلٍ. You don't have any preference over us. فَذُوقُوا الْعَذَابَ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْسِبُونَ. Now you must also taste this punishment and chastisement because of what you had been earning. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. Verily those who belie our revelations, who reject and refute our revelations, وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا عَنْهَا, and turn away from them due to arrogance and haughtiness, لا تفتح لهم ابواب السماء. gates of the heaven will not be opened for them. وَلَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ And they will not be able to enter Jannah. حَتَّى يَلِجَ الْجَمَلُ فِي سَمِّ الْخَيَاتِ Until the camel passes through the eye of the needle. وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ And in this way, we give the reward or the recompense to those people who are guilty. Now there is a hadith, according to Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that the soul of a sinful person will not be allowed to ascend to heaven, but the soul of righteous person will be welcome. It seems from some of the traditions that the Jahannam will be on this very earth. So you know they will be punished here. They will not be able to ascend to the higher places because their souls are impure. The gates of the heaven will not be opened. And also of the believers whose good deeds were less than the bad deeds, they will also remain here till such time that their souls are purified in the fire of hell. And then they will also enter, you know, and they will ascend high up. So this, you know, this proverb, Hatta yalijal jamalu fi sabil khayat, this is actually to attach to something, a condition which is impossible. Because it is impossible that a camel can pass through the eye of a needle, so it is impossible for these unbelievers that they can ever get out of the hell and enter the heaven or the paradise. And this has been used also by Hazrat Masih alayhi salam in another way. He once said, it is in the Gospel according to Saint Matthew, that the wealthy people will not be able to enter the kingdom of heaven until the camel passes through the eye of a needle. Wealthy people, he said. Because, you know, they are more engrossed in this world. Because they are in comforts and luxuries, they forget Allah. They are liable to forget Allah more than the people, you know, who are not so comfortable in this world. They anyhow call to Allah, pray to Allah. But you know, these people, and because for them it is very difficult to come in the path of Allah and to bear the hardships for iqamatuddin, to make jihad in the way of Allah. For the laborers, hard workers, already they are hard working, it's not very difficult to go to the field of battle also. But those who are accustomed to, you know, all the comforts, it becomes very difficult for them. So he says that the wealthy people will not be able to enter the kingdom of heaven until camel passes through the eye of the needle. The same. لَهُمْ مِنْ جَهَنَّمَ مِهَادٌ وَمِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ غَوَاشٌ For them there will be bed of hell, bed of fire in the hell. And in the same way the coverings, you know, the blankets will also be of fire. وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الظَّالِمِينَ And this is how we shall recompense the evildoers. And as a contrast, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَا تُكَلِّفُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا As for those who had believed, who had the real faith, and they had done and committed good deeds, and we don't charge any soul beyond its capacity. When we shall judge a soul, we shall keep in our mind what capacity we had given it. What are the potentialities that were within it? And we shall judge everybody according to the potentialities that we had given it and the capabilities and the capacities. Ulaika ashabul jannah. Now who are adjudged that they did what they could do and they passed that test. Ulaika ashabul jannah. They are the people of paradise, heaven, hum fiha khalidun. And they will remain there forever, forever. Wa nadana ma fi sudurihim min ghillin. You know, these people who will be entering paradise or heaven, in this world, there was some, you know, ill feeling towards each other also. They are human beings. Somebody said something jokingly, but he took it seriously. So there is some ill feeling among the moments also, among the believers also. There could be these things. But Allah says, when we shall make them enter in the paradise, when they will be admitted to the paradise, all the hatred and enmity will be taken away from their chests and their hearts. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ. If there is any ill feeling, if there is any hatred and enmity, we shall take it out from their hearts, so that in Jannah they will be like brothers, having no ill feeling to each other. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارُ. Beneath them, rivers will be flowing. وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي هَدَانَا لِهَذَا. And then they will be all prayers to Allah and all thanks to Allah. They say, all thanks be to Allah and all praise be to Allah who guided us to this place. وَمَا كُنَّا لِنَهْتَدِيَا. We couldn't have guidance and reach this place. لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَا اللَّهُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had not given us the guidance, if He has not guided us, it's by His blessing that we have reached here. لَقَدْ جَاتْ رُسُلُ رَبِّنَا بِالْحَقِّ. They will say, the messengers of our Lord came with the truth. Whatever they said, it came out to be true. وَنُودُوا. And then they will be called. It will be proclaimed to them. أَنْتِلْكُمُ الْجَنَّةُ وُورِسْتُمُوهَا. This heaven, this paradise, has been given to you in inheritance. You have inherited it. بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Due to your deeds, what you have earned, what you have did. They will say, it's all by Allah's bounty, by Allah's grace. We couldn't have reached it. We didn't have the right to it. We couldn't claim it on our deeds and actions only. It was all Allah's blessing that we have reached here. But Allah will say, no, it is your deeds, your good deeds. You strived in our way. You spent your time, your money, your energies, your capabilities for my cause, helping me and my messengers. So actually, you have entered here and you have inherited this garden of heaven on the basis of what we have been doing. وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ. And these people of the garden will call out to the people of the fire, أَنْ قَدْ وَجَدْنَا مَا وَعَدْنَا رَبُّنَا حَقَّا. We have found what our Lord had promised to us to be true. Whatever the promises were given to us in Quran, at the tongue of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we have come to find it, that it is absolutely true. All these promises have been fulfilled to us. فَهَلْ وَجَدْتُمْ مَا وَعَدَ رَبُّكُمْ حَقًّا. Have you also found what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised you to be true? قَالُوا نَعْمْ. They will say yes. فَأَزَّلَ مُؤَزَّنٌ بَيْنَهُمْ. Now a proclaimer will proclaim and announce between them, Allanatullahi ala zalimeen, that the curse of Allah is on the evil doers, on the transgressors. Allazina yasudduna an sabilillah. Those transgressors who stop others, bar others from the way of Allah. Want to stop them. Don't let them go in the way of Allah. Wayabghunaha iwaja. And they try to twist it. The straight path of Allah, they wanted to twist it. Or to find fault with it. Yabguna ha iwaja can have two meanings. They wanted to twist the way so that it turns away from the right path. Or they tried to find fault. Oh no, no, this is not the correct way. They tried to find faults with the right straight path so that they can take people away from the right path. Wahum bil akhirati kafirun. This is most fundamental, as I have been pointing out time and again. The fundamental thing is that they don't believe in Akhirah. They were unbelievers in Akhirah, in resurrection and the life of hereafter. وَبَيْنَهُمَا حِجَابٌ. And between them will be a fasil, as we call it, rampart, separating the two. And we find this in Surah Al-Hadid. فَظُلِمَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِسُورٍ لَهُ بَابٌ بَاطِنُهُ فِي الرَّحْمَةِ وَظَاهِرُهُ مِنْ قِبَلِهِ الْعَذَابُ. These people, you know, Ahlul Jannah, Ahlul Nar, they will be separated by a wall, a very high wall, rampart. وَبَيْنَهُمَا حِجَابٌ وَعَلَى الْعَرَافِ رِجَالٌ يَعْرِفُونَ كُلَّمْ بِسِيمَاهِمْ. On that rampart, on that high wall, there will be heights or towers, you know, as the towers used to be around the ramparts of the cities. And on those heights, there will be some people, يَعْرِفُونَ كُلَّمْ بِسِيمَاهُمْ, who will be recognizing all by their faces. Who are these people who are still neither in the Jannah nor in the hell? They are on the wall separating the Jannah and the hell, and on the towers they are sitting. They are the people, although there are so many opinions of the exegesis, Mufassirin, but you know, the one which is more accepted and in support of which there are traditions of the Prophet also, that is that when you know the way, the acts and deeds will be weighed. There will be people, and only those who believe, only actions of those will be weighed in the balance who had believed. Who had not believed, they go straight to the fire of hell. But the believers now, it will be seen whether their good deeds are more than the evil deeds. If the evil deeds are more, they will be sent to the hell. If good deeds are more, they will directly go to the heaven. But there will be people who will be balancing, you know, all the good deeds and the bad deeds, they are equal. So for some time they will stay in between, on that rampart, on that wall. And because they were, you know, in between the two, they knew each one. They knew people, you know, who were with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam also, and people who were against him also. So they will be recognized all by their faces. Kullam bisimahum. Wanada ashab al jannate. Now they will look towards the people who are in Jannah, who are in the heaven, and they will call out to them, Salamun alaykum. Peace be upon you. Lam yadkhuluha. They would not have entered it up till now because they are sitting on the rampart. Wahum yatma'un. And they will be hoping and wishing to get into that place also, where these people have already reached. وَإِذَا صُرِفَتْ أَبْصَارُهُمْ تِلْقَى أَصْحَابِ النَّارِ. And then their eyes will be turned towards the people of the fire. قَالُوا رَبَّنَا لَا تَجْعَلْنَا مَعَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. They will pray to Allah, Oh Allah, save us. Don't make us along with them. Because they have up till now neither entered hell nor heaven. So they are hoping to get entry into the heaven. But you know, when they see, maybe because, as I told you, between Khauf and Raja, Bain al Khauf wa Raja, they will having a hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will admit us to this Jannah. But they will be feeling the fear also. Rabbana la taj'alna ma'al qawmi zalimeen. Wa nada ashabul arafi rijalan ya'rifunahum bi simahum. Qalu ma aghna ankum jam'ukum wa ma kuntum tastakbirun. And these people on the heights, on that wall, separating the hell and the heaven, they will call out to the people in the fire. Ya'rifunahum bi simahum. They would be recognizing them. For example, Abu Jahl. For example, anybody else. Ma aghna ankum jam'ukum wa ma kuntum tastakbirun. Your jama'ah, and jama'ah can have two meanings here. Your jam'iyyat, your numbers, that you had many friends and many admirers and many people used to sit in your rooms, etc. And you had a hoard of wealth. All these things would not save you from this fire of hell. And all your haughtiness and all your takabbur and all your arrogance has led you to this place. Ahaulai alladhina aqsamtum. On the other side, on the Jannah, they will find Bilal, who was a slave. They will find Musab, they will find Yasir, and so on, Abu Faqih. They were the people whom they thought, they are our menials, they are our servants, they are our slaves. أَهَاُولَٰئِ الَّذِينَ أَخْسَبْتُمْ لَا يَنَالُهُمُ اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَةٍ. Are they the people who are now enjoying, you know, the blessings of Allah in the heaven, about whom you thought that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never give them any mercy? How? They are the menials. They are the low-graded people. And why are they low-graded? Because Allah had made them low-graded. If they are low-graded in this world, how can they go to heaven in the next world? That was their philosophy, their thinking, their arguing. أَهَاُولَٰئِ الَّذِينَ أَخْسَبْتُمْ. But the people on Araf, on the heights of the wall, which is intervening between the Jannah and hell, they will call and say, these people, we find them, لَا يَنَالُهُمُ الرَّحْمَةُ. You thought that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not have any mercy upon them. اُدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْكُمْ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ تَعْزَنُونَ. It has already been proclaimed to them, ओ यू, ओ बिलाल, ओ यासिर, एंटर जन्ना, एंटर द गार्डन, एंड वला खौफुन अलैकुम वला अंतुम तहज़ुनून, देयर विल बी नो फियर अपॉन यू नॉर यू विल हैव टू ग्रीव. वनादा असहाबुन नार असहाबुल जन्ना, नाउ द पीपल ऑफ द फायर विल कॉल आउट टू द पीपल ऑफ द गार्डन, अन अफीज़ू अलैना मिनल मा, pour some water on us, aw mimma razaqakumullah, or throw something from there to us, from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided you, some food, some water. qalu inna Allah harramahuma 'alal kafirin, they will reply, no, we are sorry, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared all these things forbidden for the unbelievers, we can't give you. Even if we want to give you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained us. Inna Allah harramahuma. Allah has declared them forbidden, out of bounds, alal kafirin. Allazina takhadu deenahum lahavan wa la'iba. Those who took their religion as a play and amusement only. They were never serious about these things. Wagharrathumul hayatu dunya. And the life of that world, life of the world, worldly life, it had deceived them, deluded them. فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ, today we shall ignore them, we shall forget them. كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا, as they ignored and neglected and rejected and refuted, and they didn't accept the meeting of this day. وَمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَجْحَدُونَ, and because of their denying and refuting our revelations. وَلَقَدْ جَيْنَاهُمْ بِكِتَابٍ فَصَّلْنَاهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ هُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ, and we had brought to them the book which we had explained fully and with knowledge, and which was hudan, it was a guidance and mercy, لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ, for those people who believe. هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا تَعْوِيلَهُ, they are not waiting for anything except the end result. What will be the end result of this book? What will be the end result of the dawah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What will be the end result of this world? Yawma yati ta'wiluhu yaqulu allazeena nasuhu min qabl qad ja'at rusul rabbina bil haqq. When this end result will come before them, yaqulu allazeena nasuhu, then those people will say who had ignored it, qad ja'at rusul rabbina bil haqq, our messengers had come to us with the total truth. فَهَلْ لَنَا مِنْ شُفَعَا, so are there any intercessors for us now? The only hope? We didn't accept the dawah, the call. We didn't respond positively to the call of the messengers. We didn't believe in them. Now are there any intercessors? فَيَشْفَعُوا لَنَا, so that they intercede for us. أَوْ نُرَدُّ فَنَعْمَلَ غَيْرَ الَّذِي كُنَّا نَعْمَلَ, or maybe we are sent back to the world so that we can do other than what we have been doing. Now if we are returned once to the world, we shall be doing absolutely different things. قَدْ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ, they have already destroyed themselves. وَضَلَّ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَفْتَرُونَ, and whatever concoctions they were doing, all things will vanish away. إِنَّ رَبَّكُمُ اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ, certainly your Lord is Allah who created all the heavens and the earth in 6 days. Now these 6 days are not the days of our world, of this earth. It's one revolution of the earth, you know, and it becomes one day, one night, one day, and it becomes one. Actually, the one day of moon is something else. One day of Jupiter would be something, have a different duration. One day of sun, because sun is also rotating round, you know, and it is going round some very big star also. So everything is rotating and everything is moving. Kullun yajri li ajalin musamma. So now maybe there is a day of a galaxy. Then what would be the one day of the whole of the universe? We can't imagine. It can be millions and millions of years of life, of you know, our calculations. Because in Quran we find one day of Allah is according to your calculation equal to 1,000 years. And you know, we find in the Quran 50,000 years also. كان مقداره 50 الف سنه. So there are different, you know, calculations and different sizes. So what are the sizes of those 6 days in which this kainat, this universe was created? We can't know. Maybe what they call, the scientists call, the millenniums, you know, they are the 6 millenniums, the 6 periods of time. Inna rabbakum allahu alladhi khalaqa as-samawati wal-ardha fi sittati ayamin thumma istawa 'alal 'arsh. Then he mounted and ascended the throne. We can't know what is this throne, you know, arsh of Allah is like. Yughshi al-layla an-nahar. He covers and he let the night cover the day. Yatlubuhu hasisa. And it is, you know, following it in very, you know, haughty pursuit. The day seeking it speedily. Washamsa is created the sun. Wal qamara. And the moon. Wal nujuma. And the stars. Musakharatin bi amri. They are all subservient to his command. Whatever is commanded to him, to them, they are doing it. Ala lahul khalqu wal amr. Listen, to him belongs the creation as well as the commanding. This ayah is very important. In one way, he has created something, some sun, some moon, and he has set certain instructions for it, which we call the laws of the nature. There are some laws which are governing the movement of the sun. There are a set of laws governing the movement of this earth. Certain set of laws governing the movement of the moon. Everything is obeying those laws. So these are Amr. Khalq and Amr. Allah lahul khalq wal Amr. Both belong to him. It is not that he created but somebody else is controlling. It's not that he is controlling and somebody else had created. Creation and control both belong to him. But in another sense, this ayah is most profound. There are two levels of creation, as I told you. One level of creation is pre-material creation. When the souls were created, matter was not created up till now. Souls are not material. In the same way, the angels are not material. They are from light. So actually, this is the Alamul Amr. And in that Alam, in that world, time factor is not present at all. This Amr is Kun Fayakun. He says, be, and it is done. No time. Other is the Alamul Khalq. This world of creation. Material creation, we should say here. Now, this material creation always involves time. A seed becoming a plant must take some time. There's conception in the womb of the mother, but 9 months are required. Then the baby would be fit to be delivered. So here it is time. That is why, you know, in the creation of the universe and creation of the heavens and creation of the earth, always Quran says 6 days, not kun fayakun. This has not been created in that fashion. Innama amruhu idha arada shay'an fa innama yaqulu lahu kun fayakun. That type of creation was the creation of the light, original light, which had no heat in it. You know, and that light, you know, that was pre-material era of this creation. And from that light were created the souls of the human beings and the angels. So they are not material. Our soul is not material. It doesn't belong to the world of matter. It is something from beyond. Then there was a big explosion in this light. And that is the Big Bang. And to this Big Bang our scientists have reached. Their researches and all these, their calculations, they have taken to that place. But the science of the scientists can't go beyond that. Alam-e-Amr is beyond their reach. They can never know it. Because it is fundamentally different, essentially different. It's not the world of matter. It's a pre-material, you may call it. So actually, science can discuss and see and you know the things of the material world. Not before that. And actually the souls of human beings and the angels, they belong to that period. And that is Alamul Amr. يَسَلُونَكَ عَلِ الْرُوحِ قُلِ الْرُوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. It is not خَلْقِ رَبِّي, it is أَمْرِ رَبِّي. Alam-e-Khalq is something where time is always involved. خلق السماوات والارض في سته ايام ثم استوى على العرش يغشي الليل النهار يطلبه حسيسا والشمس والقمر والنجوم مسخرات بامره الا له الخلق والامر تبارك الله رب العالمين extremely benevolent is Allah the creator the sustainer and the lord and the master of all the worlds now alamin world of matter and what should we call the other world I can't say but you know in arabic alamul khalq alamul amr in amr no time factor if the time was it was absolute time not the serial time not the passing time the serial time which we calculate through by these motions you know we are calculating due to this revolving motion of the earth one day we are calculating 1 year when the earth completes a circle around the sun so these all concepts of serial time they are based on these revolutions and these you know revolvings and these you know movements of these planets absolute time not related to any movement it's something else and they call it in philosophy there are two types of time absolute time and absolute time is dahr it has some relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is why the prophet has been reported to have said la tasubbu dahr fa inna dahra huwa Allah never abuse dahr never blame dahr what you are attributing to dahr is actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala it has some relationship absolute time is related to Allah to this world of matter it's all serial time which is produced the conception of which is produced due to these movements revolving and taking these round you know all these things between the planets so these are the things which must be kept in mind udu rabbukum tadarruan wa khufiya pray to your lord keep on praying to him calling upon him tadarruan wa khufiya with humility and in secret don't call him with loud voices he can hear whatever you say to him in your heart so why to call him with loud voice no need the best prayer is which you are praying in your loneliness when you are alone not showing off to anybody else talking to Allah alone and you need not shout tadarruan wa khufiya only what is needed is that you should be humble and number 2 secretly ask him. But another dimension will be again you know mentioned this dua has another dimension also innahu la yuhibbul mu'tadin verily he doesn't like those who transgress the limits wala tusridu fil ardi ba'da islahiha and don't produce mischief in the earth after it has been set right wad'uhu khawfan wa tama'a this is the second dimension of dua and you must call to him pray to him with khauf with fear and with tama and hope also bain al khauf wal raja so praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala number 1 humbly with humility number 2 secretly number 3 having hope that Allah will respond positively and accept my prayer and also fearing maybe due to my actions maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rejects my prayer so these are the 4 dimensions of dua and dua about dua the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said ad-du'a mukhul ibadah that is the essence of worship and in another saying he says ad-du'a huwa al-ibadah actually prayer is the worship inna rahmatullahi qareebun min al-muhsinin verily the mercy of Allah is very near to those who do good deeds or who have reached the level of ihsan both translation you must keep in mind they have risen from the level of islam and iman to that of ihsan wa huwa alladhi yursilu riyaha bushran bayna yaday rahmatihi and it is he who sends winds as glad tidings heralding his mercy that rain is coming hatta idha aqallat sahaban siqalan until then when they have carried a heavily laden cloud suqnahu li baladin mayyitin we drive it towards the land which was dry and which was lying dead there's no greenery the land is barren no greenery no signs of life but when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings the clouds there and then you know it is raining there حَتَّى اِذَا أَقَلَّتْ صَحَابًا سِقَالًا سُقْنَاهُ لِبَدَنِ الْمَيِّتِ فَأَنزَلْنَاهُ بِهِ بِهِ الْمَاءُ and then we sent down the water from it. فَأَخْرَجْنَا بِهِ مِنْ كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ and with this water we bring out from this earth all the fruits, all types of fruits. كَذَلِكَ نُخْرِجُ الْمَوْتَى in the same way we shall bring out from this earth the dead. Because the seeds were also there, but they were lying dormant. They were dead. Water came, and now those dead seeds, they become alive. They sprouted. Out of each seed, two leaves have appeared. And this led to this greenery. In this same way, you will be lying dead, buried in this clay. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends rain, and He revives the dead earth, He will revive you. كَذَلِكَ نُخْرِجُ الْمَوْتَى لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ So that we are telling to you all this, so that you may be reminded. وَالْبَلَدُ الطَّيِّبُ يَخْرُجُ نَبَاتَهُ The good land, it gives its vegetation in the best of the ways. بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِ By the command of its Lord. وَالَّذِي خَبُثَ And which is bad, the earth doesn't have any fertility. لَا يَخْرُجُ إِلَّا نَكِدَى It doesn't bring out but very little. كَذَلِكَ نُصَرِّفُ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمٍ يَشْكُرُونَ In this way we explain our ayat, our revelation for those people who are grateful. What does it mean? Rain is the same, but land is not good. It won't produce anything. Rain is the same, land is good. It's producing a lot. In the same way, if the nature of a person has perverted, Quran will not be able to bring out any good from him. If the nature of this person is correct, healthy, then Quran will, enter into it and bring forth the good which is inherent its soul. The same way as lands bad and good, in the same way the natures of people, either they are correct and healthy or they are perverted. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ We had sent Nuh to his nation. فَقَالَ يَا قَوْمِ عِبُدُ اللَّهِ And he said to them, Oh my people, worship Allah. Now this Obudu has four dimensions at least. I don't want to repeat all these. Rather I want to keep this Obudu as it is. Because repeating all the four words, that will consume much time. This is going to be repeated now time and again. Number one, worship, modes of worship, to show your reverence to someone whom you think to be God. This is one. Number two, obedience. You have to obey. That's the part and parcel of ibadah. Number three, love. You have to love Allah. And you must, whomsoever you have accepted as God, falsely or correctly, you must love him. And number four, serve. All these four words joined together go to make the sense of ibadah. So he said, Ya qawm ibudullah ba'alakum min lahim ghayru. You have no God except him. You have to worship him, you have to love him, you have to obey him, you have to serve him. Inni akhafu alaykum adhab yawmin azim. I fear on you that if you don't mend your ways, the punishment of a mighty day will take you, will overcome on you. قال الملأ من قومه The chiefs of his nation said to him, إنا لنراك في ضلال مبين We see you, we find you in a manifest error. You have been mistaken somehow. قال يا قوم ليس بي ضلالة He replied, No, my people, I am not in error. ولكني رسول من رب العالمين On the other hand, I am the messenger from the Lord of all the worlds. أُبَلِّغُكُمْ رِسَالَاتِ رَبِّي I am conveying to you the messages of my Lord. بَعَنْصَهُ لَكُمْ I am most sincere to you. I am advising you sincerely. وَعَلَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ And you don't know what I know from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That knowledge has not come to you. أَوَعَجِبْتُمْ أَنْ جَاءَكُمْ ذِكْرٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ You are wondering that a reminder has come to you, ala rajulin minkum, to a man from your among yourselves, a man of your nation, to him a reminder has come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you are wondering it. Layunzirakum, and this reminder has come what for? So that he may warn you. Wale tattaqu, so that you can have taqwa. You may have taqwa, you may be able to save yourselves. Wala'allakum turhamun, and so that mercy should be shown to you. Fakazzabuhu, but they rejected him, belied him, refuted him. Fanjaynahu wallazina ma'ahu fil fulk, so we saved and delivered him and those who were with him in the ark, in the big boat and ship that he made under the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This we will find in Surah Hud, inshallah. وَأَغْرَقْنَا الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا, and we drowned all of them who had belied our revelations. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمًا عَمِينَ, surely they were the blind people. وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا, now you know this nation was the first nation. Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam was the first messenger of Allah. Please note it. Before him we have on the record three prophets. Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was a prophet, not a messenger. Hazrat Idris alayhi salatu wasalam, he was a prophet, not a messenger. Hazrat Shis alayhi salam, he was a prophet, not a messenger. The first messenger of Allah is Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. Then you know the people who were saved with Nuh, three of his sons. So now the nations of the world are the progeny of three sons of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, Sam, Ham, and Yafis. And Quran only discusses the history of the Semitic nations, who are the progeny of Sam alayhi salatu wasalam, who was one of the sons of Nuh. The other son, Yafis, his progeny migrated to the north, because the area which is you know today as Kurdistan, this is the place where the nation of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam was living. And perhaps the humanity was till that time restricted to this area only. And here came the flood, and the ark rested with Judy. And it is somewhere where Armenia and Turkey and Russia, they go to meet, you know. That's the place where this Jabal-e-Judy is. And some, you know, pilots have seen a structure on the top of that mountain which resembles an ark and a boat. But it has not, been discovered up till now. Maybe because Quran says that we have preserved it as a sign. So that sign will come to light one day. But from that, that place, now three sons of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, their progeny spread. One went downwards toward the south, and these are the Semitic nations. Iraq, Syria, they were inhabited, and then the Arabian Peninsula. These are the Semitics. And the Yafis, sons of Yafis, they migrate across the mountain range of the Central Asia, and then to the left to the right. The European nations, the Russians especially, and the Chinese and Mongols, they are all progeny of Hazrat Yafis alayhi salatu wasalam. And the middle, Ham, they went to west and to east. To east towards India, Indian subcontinent, and to west toward Egypt, etc., and Sudan. So they are the progeny of Hazrat Ham alayhi salatu wasalam. Quran gives us the history mainly of the Semitic nations. Among the Semitic nations, after the people of Nuh, arose this people of Ad, a very strong nation. So to them came Hazrat Hud. وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا, and to Ad, to the nation of Ad, we sent their brother. And his name was Hud alayhi salatu wasalam. Qala ya qawm ibudullah ma lakum min ilahin ghayru, he said the same thing. Oh my nation, make ibadah towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be abds to him, and you have no lord, no god except him. Afala tattaqun, don't you have taqwa? Don't you want to save yourselves? Qala al mala'u alladhina kafaru min qawmihi inna lanaraka fi safahatin, so the people from his nation who were the chiefs, they said to him, we find you in folliness. You seem to have become a fool. وَإِنَّا لَنَظُنُّكَ مِنَ الْكَاذِبِينَ, and we think that you are lying. You are telling us a lie. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ لَيْسَ بِي سَفَاهَةٍ, he said, no, oh my nation, there is no folly with me. وَلَكِنِّي رَسُولٌ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, On the other hand, I am a messenger from the Lord of all the worlds. Ubalighukum risalat Rabbi. I am conveying to you the messages of my Lord. Wa ana lakum nasirun amin. And I am for you a trustworthy advisor. Ab ajibtu an jaakum zikrum min rabbikum. Are you wondering over this? That a zikr, a reminding has come to you from your Lord, ala rajulim minkum, through a person, on a person from amongst you. لَيُنْزِرَكُمْ, so that he may warn you. وَذْكُرُوا إِذْ جَعَلَكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قَوْمِ نُوحٍ. Just remember, recall, Allah Ta'ala made you the successors after the nation of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. And the place of this nation was in the southern part of Arabian Peninsula. It's the worst type of desert today. It was a very fertile land. And now here, a planet, you know, which are encircling our earth, you know, these satellites, they have discovered that city of Shaddad. Shaddad was the name of the king of Aad. And that city, you know, that has been discovered, it is lying buried in the desert deep. And that is a very bad desert now. But there was a very big civilization here, very strong nation. The southern part of the Arabian Peninsula. مِن بَعْدِ قَوْمِ نُوحٍ وَزَادَكُمْ فِي الْخَلْقِ بَسْطَةً. And he increased you very much in your statures and your body. وَاسْكُرُوا عَلَىٰ اللَّهِ. And you must remember the bounties of Allah that have been upon you. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so that you become successful. قَالُوا أَجَيْتَنَا لِنَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ وَحْدَهُ. They said to him, have you come to us that we should worship only Allah alone? What does it mean? They worshipped Allah also and other gods also. This is shirk. Shirk doesn't mean denying the existence of Allah. Shirk means you believe in a big Allah, the great Allah, the supreme Allah, and along with that supreme Allah, small aliha, small gods, small devis and devatas. This is shirk. Now what was Hud saying? Don't worship anyone else except Allah. And this is what they are saying. Ajaytana lina'budu Allah wahdahu. You have come to us that we should give up all the worships of the other deities and other lords and other gods and goddesses and worship Allah alone. Wa nadara ma kana ya'budu aba'una. And we leave those whom our forefathers have been worshipping. Fatina bima ta'iduna. So okay, bring what you are threatening us with. You say that azab will come, punishment will come. Bring that punishment. In kunta min as-sadiqin, if you are really true. قَالَ قَدْ وَقَعَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ رِجْسٌ. Hazrat Hud said to him, indeed curse and wrath from your Lord has already fallen upon you. وَغَضَبْ, his wrath has fallen upon you. أَتُجَادِلُونَنِ فِي أَسْمَاءٍ سَمَّيْتُمُوهَا أَنْتُمْ وَآبَاؤُكُمْ. You are disputing with me and arguing against me about the mere names that were invented by you or your forefathers. Who are these gods and goddesses? Where has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You believe in one Allah? Now give me the argument. Where Allah has told that I have these, you know, assistants also and these gods and goddesses also? Allah has told us. He's created malaika. Malaika are managing this world. They are the bureaucracy. They are the civil service of this universal government, divine government. But we don't worship them. Worship is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Although they are very exalted. They were created out of light. They are very near to their Lord, al-malaikatul muqarrabun. But we can't worship them. We worship only Allah. So he said, atujadilunani fi asma'in sammaytumuha antum wa aba'ukum. You have invented some names, you and your forefathers. Ma nazzalallahu biha min sultan. Allah has not sent down any authority for them, any certificate for them. فَانْتَذِرُوا إِنِّي مَعَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُنْتَذَرِينَ. So wait, I am also waiting with you. فَانْجَيْنَاهُ وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ. The same thing happened. We saved him and those who were with him, who had believed in him. بِرَحْمَةٍ مِنَّا, by mercy from us. وَقَطَعْنَا دَابِرَ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا. And we cut the roots of that nation who had belied and refuted and rejected the revelations of Allah, our ayat. وَمَا كَانُوا مُؤْمِنِينَ, and they were not to believe. وَإِلَىٰ سَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا. Now when this nation was destroyed, Hazrat Hud alayhi salam and the Mu'mineen, along, they migrated from this place. And they now settled in the northwestern corner of the Arabian Peninsula. This is called Hijr. This, you know, because Samud lived there, and there are found even today, they used to carve out their homes in the stones. And I have visited that place myself also. And beautiful homes, very big halls they have carved in, you know, in granite rocks. And the rocks are very strong. They are standing up till now. Although I think they are at least 3,000 years old. Rather 4 or 5,000 years old. The same time as of Harappa and as of Mohenjo-Daro. That is one time in which these civilizations were flourishing throughout the world. That is the time of Samud. Because much before Ibrahim. Ibrahim alayhi salam was nearly 4,000 years from today. So before him, actually they are 5,000. And you know, they're remnants, you know, they are present there. So this is the Samud. And when the Samud also went on the wrong path, then Allah sent to them Hazrat Saleh alayhi salatu wasalam. Wa ila Samud akhahum Saliha. And to Samud we sent their brother Saleh. Qala ya qawmi budullah malakum ilahin ghayru. The same call. You must be bondsmen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have no Lord except Him. Qad ja'atkum bayyinatun min rabbikum. A clear sign has come to you from your Lord. They demanded it. Show us a miracle. This, you know, this rock, a pregnant she camel should come out at once from it, like a ball from the blue. And this miracle was shown to them. Qad ja'atkum bayyinatun min rabbikum. This clear miracle has come to you from your Lord. Hadhihi naqatullah. Now this is camel of Allah. She camel of Allah. Lakum ayatan. And it is a sign for you. Fazaruha. Leave it alone. Taqul fi ardillah. That it may graze wherever it like on the earth of Allah. Wala tamassuha bisu'in. Don't touch it with any ill intention, bad intention. Fayakhudakum azabun aleem. Then you know a very painful torment will overcome you. And just remember, after the Aad were destroyed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you the successors after Aad. وَبَوَّأَكُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And He has established you in this earth. تَتَّخِذُونَ مِنْ سُهُولِهَا قُسُورًا. In the plains, you are building palaces and fortresses. وَتَلْحِتُونَ الْجِبَالَ بُيُوتًا. And you are carving out homes in the mountains, in the rocks. Now because those palaces, they have vanished. 5,000 years, they can't be seen now. But the homes that they carved in the rocks, they are still there. And you know, you can see the pictures of that. Maulana Madhudi has included those pictures in his Tafhim al-Quran. And you can find it in so many places. فَاسْكُرُوا عَلَىٰ اللَّهِ. So you must remember the bounties of Allah that have come to you. وَلَا تَعْصُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ مُفْسِدِينَ. And don't go about in the earth making mischief. قَالَ الْمَلَوُ الَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا مِنْ قَوْمِهِ. The same reply. The chiefs of the nation said to him, لِلَّذِينَ اسْتُدْعِفُوا لِمَنْ آمَنَا. And they said to whom? To those people who were oppressed and they had believed in Hazrat Saleh alayhi salam. Just as the slaves of Makkah. It's actually a mirror is being shown to what was happening at Makkah at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. History is repeating itself. Whatever you are doing today, the chiefs of Aad and chiefs of the Qawm of the nation of Nuh and the chiefs of the people of Saleh, they have all been saying the same things. They have all been doing the same things. So they said, those haughty people said to those people, meek peoples who had accepted the faith of Hazrat Saleh, أَتَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ صَالِحًا مُرْسَلٌ بِرَبِّهِ. Do you know, do you believe that Saleh has been sent from his Lord? قَالُوا إِنَّا بِمَا أُرْسِلَ بِهِ مُؤْمِنُونَ. They said, you know, yes, we believe, and we believe in all that he had been sent with. قَالَ الَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا إِنَّا بِالَّذِي آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ كَافِرُونَ. And they replied with arrogance and haughtiness, okay, then what you believe in, we deny it, we repudiate it, we reject it. فَأَقَرُوا النَّاقَةَ. And they killed the she-camel. وَعَتَوْا الْأَمْرِ رَبِّهِمْ. And they defied their Lord's command. وقالوا يا صالح تنا بما تعدنا ان كنت من المرسلين. And they said, oh Salih, now bring to us that punishment that you said, that if you kill this, if you touch this camel, this she camel, with any bad intentions, a very painful torment will come over you. So bring it now. In kunta minal mursaleen, if you are really a messenger sent from the Lord. فَأَخَذَتْهُمُ الرَّجْفَةُ. So an earthquake overtook them. فَأَصْبَحُوا فِي دَارِهِمْ جَاثِمِينَ. And they became in their dwellings, lying dead, in prostrating conditions. فَتَوَلَّى عَنْهُمْ. He turned his back to him, to them. وَقَالَ يَا قَوْمِ لَقَدْ أَبْلَغْتُكُمْ رِسَالَةَ رَبِّي. And he said, oh my nation, oh my people, I had conveyed to you the messages of my Lord. وَنَسَاتُ لَكُمْ. And I wanted to advise you sincerely, to save you from this disaster. وَلَكِنْ لَا تُحِبُّونَ النَّاصِحِينَ. But you don't like, you don't love those people who advise you sincerely. وَلُوتًا. In the same way we sent Lut alayhi salatu wassalam. Now he is a contemporary of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam. Hazrat Ibrahim and Lut were related. He was nephew. Hazrat Ibrahim was the uncle of Lut, and Lut was nephew of Ibrahim. And Hazrat Lut was sent to this Transjordan area, now today Jordan. This is the area intervening between Palestine and Iraq. This was the area, there was a very big civilization over here, and two very big towns of Sodom and Gomorrah. Amura they called in Arabic, and English Gomorrah. Gomorrah and Sodom. Sodomy is from Sodom. Sodomy. Because this was, you know, the most heinous thing that they were doing. Well, Lutan is called a Qawmihi. And we sent Lut also. And he said the same thing. And along with that, those things, in addition, he said to his nation, Atatun al Fahishata ma sabakakum biha min ahadi min al alameen. Are you doing and committing such a shameful act which no nation had done before you? This is the most shameful. What is that? Innakum latatuna rijala shahwatan. You approach men sexually. Min duni nisa. Leaving aside women. Allah has created women for you. That is the nature. And you are approaching men, males, for your gratification, sensual gratification, sexual gratification. Bal antum qawmun musrifun. No, you are people who have exceeded all limits of decency. Wama kana jawabu qawmihi. But there was no reply from his people. Illa an qalu akhrijuhum min qaryatikum innahum unasun yatatakharun. They said, oh, turn them out from your town. They are very pious people, very clean and very pure. It was a satire, you know. They are very clean people. They shouldn't live with us. Turn them out. فَانْجَيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ. We saved him and his family. إِلَّا امْرَأَتَهُ. Except his wife. كَانَتْ مِنَ الْغَابِرِينَ. She was among those who lingered behind, who remained behind. وَأَمْطَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ مَطَرًا. And then we sent a rain upon them. مَطَرًا. And that rain was of, not of water, out of stones. A rain of stones came. فَانْظُرْ كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. So see and look what was the end and result of those people who were guilty. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ وَنَفَعْنِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ بِالْآيَاتِ وَالذِّكْرِ الْحَكِيمِ.